Bruce Willis was in town filming 12 Monkeys with Brad Pitt, and there was a gentleman who was walking around his office bragging everybody how he looked like Bruce Willis. So what they did, they decided to play a little joke on him, and they pretended that they had seen a production assistant in a bar and gave the production assistant for this film this guy's picture, and to expect a phone call from the people on the film. So this guy believes that he is a double for Bruce Willis, and I decided to call him as somebody representing the film 12 Monkeys.
Hello?
David?
Yes.
David, it's Jerry Aldini, Philadelphia Casting Company.
How are you?
How are you?
Good.
Listen, I received a... Did you send us your picture? I got a picture of you from Alan Gasher. Does that name sound familiar?
Yes, it does. One of my friends gave him the picture.
Okay.
Do you have the picture in front of you?
No, I don't.
Oh, okay.
I have any other office.
Okay. One of my friends who became friendly with him, I asked to get my picture because I wanted to see if you were... doing any casting or whatsoever.
Mm-hmm. Well, it so happens we showed this to the associate director.
Okay.
And he flipped out. I mean, you really do resemble Bruce Willis.
Do I really?
Yeah.
I mean, I get it a lot.
Yeah. Do you get the people stop you on the street and tell you?
Yeah, especially in that picture, I was growing a goatee, and I have a full on now. So
here's the deal.
Okay.
We need a stand-in for Bruce.
Okay.
And we need somebody real quick.
Okay. How quick?
Well, immediately. Like within the next couple of days.
Okay.
Do you know anything about the film?
No, I don't.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Bruce actually turns into a monkey in the movie.
Okay.
We had a problem last week because he's allergic to the makeup.
Okay.
And so we need somebody to actually not only stand in for him, but actually do some dialogue.
Okay.
Now, are you a member of any Actors Guild?
To tell you the honest truth, no.
All right, we can get you signed up for that real quick. It's no deal. All you have to do is fill out, some forms.
Okay.
Now, we want to know if you're interested in coming down here and not just so much standing in for Bruce, but actually getting a part in the film as Bruce Willis in the parts where he's doing changing over as the monkey.
Okay. Now, what does that involve or entail? Could you tell me?
That entails makeup, it entails costuming, it entails some dialogue.
Mm-hmm.
I really do want to use you.
Okay.
We're going to pay handsomely.
Okay.
We're going to pay $2,500 a day.
Okay.
Does that sound good?
Fine. But what is the, what is mainly the movie about? Could you tell me?
The movie, the brief synopsis of the film, it's almost a fantasy.
Okay.
Men turning into monkeys and how they see the world as monkeys. And these men are men who are down on their luck, down and out, and they think that their lives are terrible. And the movie is all about showing you the other side of life.
Okay.
All right? Now, in addition to putting you in the makeup, we're going to have you doing dialogue, but Bruce would be doing the dialogue as the monkey. Okay?
Okay.
Doing monkey dialogue. Now, we're thinking that it might be advantageous for you and for us if you could just actually do the dialogue.
Okay.
And the dialogue just consists of monkey sounds and monkey noises, that kind of deal.
Okay.
You know, going from human to monkey.
Okay, gotcha.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So if you could, now I really don't want to have you down here because I've got your picture. And all I need, I'm going to just run a little tape here if you don't mind, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And I want to get all your sounds, okay? So I can play this for the associate producer, and he can run it over to the director. All right, I'm going to run the tape here and just, feel it. You just be it. You're the monkey. You're in the monkey outfit. Just be the monkey and give me some monkey sounds. I'm going to hit the tape here. All right, anytime you're ready. Roll them. Action.
How's that?
All right, that's not bad. Can you give it to me with a little bit more energy?
How's that?
Man, that's damn good. I mean, that is excellent.
Okay.
Now, there are a couple different scenes as the monkey.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to take you through different emotions, okay?
Mm-hmm.
You, this is a scene where you've just lost your best friend.
Okay.
And the monkey starts... Excuse me, I got a cold.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
I've had this cold for like 2 weeks.
What, it's flu?
Yeah, just getting over it.
Oh, okay.
Okay. All right, the monkey... I'm sorry, I got something stuck in my throat.
Don't worry about it.
I apologize. The monkey has just lost his best friend. Okay, and you're very sad, you're emotional, and I want you to take me through a kind of a crying, like a you're remorseful, that kind of a thing.
Like a crying remorseful?
Yeah, like a crying monkey. Give me the crying monkey.
It's got to be some kind of like rumbling sound.
Yeah, that was good. Man, I tell you, you sure you've never done this before?
No, I haven't done this before.
I'm going to give you one more emotion. I've got two of them here because I want to give them a variation of emotions, okay?
Okay.
This is where you actually, you know Madeline Stowe's in the film?
Yes.
She turns into a monkey.
Okay.
And you and Madeline have a romantic moment. I'm going to play the part of Madeline, okay, the female monkey.
Okay.
And you are, of course, you're going to be Bruce Willis's character, and you're really starting to come on to me, and let's see how that works. And I'll be playing the part, and let's see how it happens.
Okay.
Go ahead. That was fabulous.
Okay.
Man, you are something else. All right. Here's the deal.
Go ahead.
I think we've got something really to work with here. You really are uninhibited, and you really sound fabulous.
Okay.
And I'm going to, I've got the tape here.
Mm-hmm.
And I am going to give the tape to the director.
Okay.
The director's name is Paul Barsky from Y100 Radio.
Oh, God.
And you've been phone scammed.
Why do you do this to me? Why? I don't understand this. Come on. Why do you have to do this to me?
I want you to do the sound of an embarrassed monkey now.
This is
the first time I almost couldn't go through the whole thing.
Why?
Because when you started doing the sad monkey, I just almost lost it, man. This is from your wonderful friends over
there. Yeah, I know. I know exactly who it's from.
All right, buddy.
Thank you.
Hey, one more time. All right, so let's talk about what happened yesterday. Mm-hmm. The passing of Jerry Garcia, the Deadheads mourning, grieving, the vigils being held in Jersey and Center City.
Cincinnati.
Everywhere.
All over
the world.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so I figured we would try to see if we can get hold of Jerry this morning for all the fans, for all the Deadheads who are listening this morning, hopefully. Now, for this to work, we've got to all get into it. Sherry's crossing herself, of course,
right.
Reading the rosary, doing the rosary, whatever
right.
You're doing. And we had all hands now. Lower the lights a little bit.
Okay.
And psychically, I can bring spirits through. Look, Shem's really closing his eyes.
And holding our hands.
And holding hands, too. Okay, so let's try to bring the spirit of Jerry Garcia through and see if we can get him in heaven. Come in, heaven. Come in, heaven. Come in, heaven. Feel a little dizzy? You guys feel anything? Something's happening. Stop laughing, Jerry. Come in, heaven.
Hello, heaven.
Yes, Jerry Garcia's room, please.
Hold on. Hello?
Jerry?
Yeah.
Barsky from Y100.
Hey, man, how you doing? I heard you're going to be calling. How's it going?
Good. How you doing?
I messed up. Hold on a minute. How you doing, man?
Good. Listen, welcome to heaven. I wanted to, I'm always the one to call whenever somebody dies, and I just wanted to see how you're feeling, how you're doing and stuff. Did you make it up there okay?
Yeah, it was pretty good. I had a little problem getting through the pearly gates, because of all the drugs I did and stuff, but because Peter was a little rough, but, I kind of talked him into letting me in.
Really? What'd you do?
I got him stoned. It's wild. Hey, hold on, man. Someone wants to talk to you.
Okay. We're getting more than we bargained for.
Hey, man. How are you?
Sammy?
How are you, man? Listen, I just wanted to stop by and say hi. I knew you were going to be on the blower this morning, man. But I'm so happy Garcia's here.
Really? I didn't know you were a Grateful Dead fan.
Well, I'm not really a Grateful Dead fan, man, but finally now we've got some good hooch up here. Because, you know, before this moment, you know, before he began up here, man, I had to get my grass from, you know, Abe Lincoln and Einstein. You know, and as much as Einstein was a genius, man, you know, he grew some really harsh grass, man. So it's really cool to have him here. And we were just sitting around blowing joints and doing stuff and talking about old days. I've got to run because they're doing the theatrical version of Yes, I Can, my autobiography, man, and I'm doing dinner theater. And so I'll be heading out. Hang on, somebody else wants to talk to you, man.
All right.
Somebody else.
Hey, how are you, kid?
Who's this?
It's a Bambino, Babe Ruth.
Babe, how are you?
I'm a fine kid. I'm making room in my place for Mickey Mantle. He's heading up here. Well, number 7, I'm making room for him.
I know, he's not doing very well.
I'm excited about having him up here, kid.
Why would that be?
Got another drinking buddy. You know, Mick's a nice guy. We'll go out and have a good time.
What about Garcia? You happy that he's here? Because, you know, he's bringing you the hooch and stuff.
I'm not into that, man. Nah, just give me, you know, a case of beer and a bucket of hot dogs and a couple hookers. I'm happy. All right, kid, I got to get going. One more thing, kid.
Yeah?
Keep your eye on the ball, sweetheart. Well, yeah, sounds like Telly Savalas there for a second.
All right, well, see you, Bambi. You know, you put Jerry back on real quick.
What's it talking, man?
Hey, how you doing? Hey, listen, one more thing I got to say, and I really didn't have a chance to say this to my fans and stuff before I die, but I wanted to say this to all the deadheads, and I think the best way I could say this is with three little words.
And what would that be?
Get alive. Jesus Christ. I'm glad I'm dead. I'm away from you people for crying out loud. Tie my freaking ties, eat my ice cream, but leave me alone. Jeez. You know, go do something else. Get some community service. Do some work. Do some housework. Mow the freaking lawn.
Get a job.
Get a job. Thank you, Tim. Jesus. What? What's that? Cool. Hey, you know what to get high?
Who?
Nixon, man. I'll see you, man. Bye-bye.
This woman was scheduled to bring her car in for work at a dealership, some service. And she had a concern about a warranty on the car, and I called from the dealership to answer her questions.
Hello?
Dawn DiGiorgio, please.
This is her.
Dawn, this is Fred Hanratty from Quality.
Uh-huh.
How are you?
Okay, how are you?
You're scheduled to bring in your car tomorrow?
Yes.
I wanted to go over a couple of things.
Okay.
What needs to be worked on? The brake pads?
No, it's got the pulsation, and my brother-in-law had looked at it, and what was it? The rotors have to be cut or something. I'm not exactly sure.
All right, now how many miles do you have in the car?
41.
41,000?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you know this isn't covered under the warranty.
No, the lady told me it was.
No, it isn't.
50,000.
No, actually, if you look in the contract agreement, it's 40,000.
Of course, because when I called you, there was under 40,000.
Yeah, well,
and
it's...
you just couldn't get it in.
It's 40,000.
Yeah. All right, then, just forget it.
Forget what?
I don't want you just to fix it, then.
Well, who's going to fix it, then, for
I'll
you?
I'll get my brother-in-law to fix it.
He'll probably botch it up.
My brother-in-law is a mechanic.
Your brother-in-law is an idiot.
That's real nice of you to, you know, accuse my relatives of being an idiot.
Well, because he shouldn't be working on the car. We're the professionals.
Oh, you're the professional. Yeah. Let me tell you something. This man works on 10 ambulances a day.
Yeah?
And he keeps them on the street.
Well, do you drive an ambulance?
Yes, I do.
What is it, a 1994 ambulance that you drive?
Yes, I do.
That's not what you drive. You drive a Lincoln Mark?
Yes, I do. I own an ambulance company. I want to speak to your supervisor now.
You want to speak to my supervisor?
Yes.
All right, hold on for a second.
Thank you.
Hang on.
Do you believe that this guy just called my brother-in-law an idiot? Yeah, because I said I don't want you to do it, because it's not under warranty now.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes, who's this, please?
This is Dawn DiGiorgio.
Yes,
who am I speaking to?
My name is Mr. McCratchin.
Okay, Mr. McCratchin, I have a little problem.
Mm.
All right. I was just speaking to your serviceman, Fred.
Yes.
I don't like his attitude.
What did he say?
He called my brother-in-law an idiot.
Why
okay?
did he?
And then he's arguing with me about what I drive.
What? Why did he call your brother-in-law an idiot?
Because I told him when he told me that this car would not be covered under warranty, mm-hmm. that I didn't want you to do the work.
Right.
And he says, well, then who's going to do it?
Right.
I said, my brother-in-law will do it.
Right.
And he says, well, your brother-in-law is an idiot. Why don't you bring it to us? We're the professionals.
Exactly.
Exactly?
Yes. Why don't you bring it to us? We are the professionals.
Because yous are going to charge me an arm and a leg, and my brother-in-law is not.
Yeah, but your brother-in-law is going to ruin it because he's an idiot.
Oh, he is.
Yes.
This is good.
I don't know your brother-in-law, but I'm guessing, you know, if he's not a professional, then he's a complete idiot.
Oh, really?
Yes.
My brother-in-law keeps 10 ambulances a day on the street.
What is the name of his company? You see what
Look,
I mean?
It doesn't matter.
So he doesn't have
what
a company.
The name is. The point is.
He's an idiot.
Oh, really?
And you're an idiot.
Oh, and I'm an idiot.
Because you're not bringing your car to us to have it fixed.
Get me the owner of this company now.
All right, hold on. Hold on.
Now I'm an idiot. Now I'm the idiot. Yeah, I was talking to a McCraft.
Hello?
Yes. Who am I speaking with?
Bob Gretchen.
Okay, Bob. This is Dawn DiGiorgio.
Yes.
Okay, I got a little problem.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I've been buying vehicles from you for the last 6 years.
Yes.
All right, every 2 years I buy a new vehicle from you.
Right.
Every year I increase on what I'm buying.
Mm-hmm. Right?
I just bought a Lincoln Mark 8 off of you.
Okay.
Okay? Matter of fact, it was my understanding that it was your vehicle.
Right.
Okay?
All righty, I remember that
now,
car,
I've had
yes.
problems since day one with this vehicle when it comes to the brakes.
Yes.
I've brought it back time after time for
yes.
the brakes.
Yes.
Give me a minute, because your service guy really has me wound.
What did he do?
He called me an idiot.
Well, why did he do that?
Because I told him when the vehicle... First off, I had a Fred, okay?
Yes, friend had
Fred decided to call my brother-in-law an idiot.
Now
because
what?
Because I told him that I didn't want to bring the vehicle in because it was not under warrant.
Now, that's completely wrong.
Okay, so then he proceeded to say, well, who are you going to get it to fix it? I said, my brother-in-law will fix it.
He never should have called your brother-in-law an idiot.
No, he shouldn't have.
Should have called you an idiot.
Oh, I'm an idiot?
Why would you go to an unprofessional to have your car fixed?
All right, let me explain something about my brother-in-law.
I'm sorry, I don't mean to call you an idiot.
Okay, well, I don't think that's a good idea right now because I'm a little wound and I think maybe you ought to just listen to me for a minute.
A moron would be along the lines of what I'm talking about.
You're calling me a moron.
I'm sorry,
I
continue.
Think that you're a moron for speaking to your customers like this. I deal with the public every single day,
mm-hmm.
and I would never call anyone a moron or an idiot.
What about a knucklehead?
All right. Well, regardless, a moron and an idiot are very strong words.
Imbecile?
Okay.
All right. I'm sorry, continue.
Yeah. No, I don't think that this is a good idea. You know, I even rent vans off of you. Now I'm going to have to call Barbara and cancel
You know, I can refer you to a great mechanic. Let me give you my mechanic's name. His name is Barsky from
Y100. You guys are a bunch of assholes.
Oh, man.
Our traffic person, Kim Douglas, a.k.a. Kim Douglug, recently went under the knife for a breast implant surgery, and we decided to pen a little ditty for it, and it goes something like this.
Kim's a new-breasted girl.
Tell us what she's like.
A new-breasted girl.
You know she's really sad.
In the lingerie department.
Looking for support.
Her old bras just won't fit her.
We've heard from the reports.
Some wonder why she did it. Was she wrong or was she right?
Well, just looking at your cleavage, Kim, those boobs are out of sight.
Dug-a-lug-a. They're perky and they stand straight up.
Dug-a-lug-a.
Yeah, she's a full seat.
Dug-a-lug-a.
They're worried about her health now that the job is done. It's saline in those breasts, and it's not silicone. Her breasts were nice before.
Now they're even better.
We really like the way
she's filling out her sweater.
We know it was a tough decision. Yes, we know.
Yes, we know.
Yes, we know. Can we stand by you? Really hope you like them, hope you're happy that you're stacked.
But if you're disappointed, you can always give them back. Dug-a-lug-a.
They're perky and they stand straight up.
Dug-a-lug, 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 dug-a-lug.
Yeah, she's a full C-cup.
Dug-a-lug, dug-a-lug, dug-a-lug.
Don't worry about her health now that the job is done. It's saline in those breasts and it's not silicone.
All right, this guy was all set to go on a vacation with his wife to Venezuela, and I called from the travel agency to give him a bit of bad news.
Hello, Stanley, may I help you?
Yes, Mr. Stanley?
Yes.
This is Mike Blade with the travel agency.
Yes, Mike.
We have a big problem.
What is it?
The trip has been canceled.
The what?
Your trip to Venezuela?
Are you kidding me?
Have you been listening to the news?
No.
Okay, Libya has just invaded Venezuela.
Are you pulling my leg?
No, I'm not. And they're not allowing any flights going in and out of the country until order is restored.
Oh, boy.
And unfortunately, the tickets are non-refundable.
Now what do we do?
I could try to send you someplace else for a vacation, but you're out 1844.
Oh, my God.
Yep. Yep. Any other place you may be interested in going?
I don't have any idea where we would want to go.
What about Greenland? You got a fine vacation package in Greenland.
Why the hell would I want to go to Greenland?
Well, there's a lot to do up there. Have you ever been to Greenland?
No, I've never been to Greenland.
It's a great, great place. A lot of fun.
I've got $1,800 invested in this trip.
Exactly.
Okay. I don't want to go anywhere it's going to cost me much more than $1,800.
All right. Let me see what I've got you for $1,800. We could get you over to Bosnia. It's a safe tour. You'll be touring from inside a bus. You've got bulletproof glass.
I'm not going.
All right, I'm just trying to come up with some ideas for you.
I'm going to have my wife call you because I don't have any idea.
Well, I tell you what, but I'll call your wife directly. You don't need to call her. I'll take care of it. I'll call her directly. We'll work this out. Let me take handle it because I feel kind of responsible. I mean, even though I didn't invade Venezuela, but I still feel like I want to help you out here.
Okay.
I will talk to her, and I don't want you to pick up that phone. I want you to keep that phone line open because I'm going to call you right back.
Okay.
I want to work this thing out.
Okay.
All right?
All right.
All right.
So then we proceeded to pretend to call his wife, and then we called him back.
Bill Stanley.
Yes, Billy?
Yeah.
This is Mike Bladen from the travel agency again.
Yeah, Mike.
I just spoke with your wife.
What'd
and
you
we
say?
We have worked out a great vacation trip. I just this package just
First
opened
of all,
up.
Mike, how much of the money I had to pay on this goddamn trip? I mean, we only got $1,800 now.
Right. Right.
Okay.
But let me tell you what I've got first, okay?
All right.
This is a week's a vacation mm-hmm. to Tibet.
To where?
Tibet. In the Himalayas.
Why the f***? Did you talk to her about Tibet?
Yeah, I mentioned to her and I said that the Dalai Lama, who is
Dalai
the spirit...
Dalai Lama? What the hell is that?
The Dalai Lama is a spiritual leader. Of
wait a minute.
The Tibetan monks.
I
just spoke to her. She said she is open for a spiritual awakening in the Himalayas. And
she's open for a spiritual awakening, all right, but not. I'm not going to Tibet or whatever.
Can I explain something to you?
Before, number one is.
Wait. Before you get a look side, let me explain something, Billy, okay? Let me just. Or is it Billy? Is it Billy or Billy Ray?
It's Billy Ray. Okay. I mean, Billy. I mean, right now, it's either one. You will call me. I don't care.
All right, Billy, let me explain something here. You seem to have a lot of hostility and anger in you, and this is a perfect thing for someone like you to cleanse the soul, get the anger out. You know, the Dalai Lama is a man of peace, he's a man of love, that he is he's a leader of all the Tibetan monks, and this is a beautiful, beautiful vacation up in the Himalayas. You've never been there. I mean, you'll have the best time of your life. Trust me. It's a conference of all the lamas.
Oh, trust me. What do you mean, all the llamas?
Thousands of llamas will be there. It's a llama convention. And the Dalai Lama will be there.
Wait a minute. I'm not going to Tibet with a bunch of llamas, I'll tell you that right now. If these are llamas, llamanese, or llamas, or whatever you call these people, I am not going over there.
This is a heck of a vacation. The actual price on this vacation is?
It's $1,844, you just told me.
No, it's $4,250, and I'm giving it to you for $1,844 because I feel bad the fact that Libya has invaded Venezuela.
I had no...
That's another thing. What the hell does Libya have? What relationship is that to Venezuela?
I have no idea. It's Gaddafi. He's out of his mind. What do you want from me? I don't know anything about it. I'm trying to get you on a vacation. Let me tell you something. I've got you booked February 18th on a flight to Tibet. The Dalai Lama will meet you there at the airport.
Oh, Christ.
And you will actually ride in the Lama Mobile?
No, I'm not going to Tibet. I'll tell you that right now. I got to talk to my wife, but I am not going to Tibet. Number one is I have a vacation.
Right.
The thing that I was looking forward to is going to the sun.
Okay.
I don't know what Asia is. This country.
Just by talking to you, you have a lot of anger. Could you just breathe in and breathe out? This is what the Dalai Lama will do with you in the Himalayas. He'll get you to...
I don't need the Dalai
breathe.
Lama.
Come on.
Tell me how to breathe and stuff like that. That's my wife. She wants to do this kind of stuff. That's up to her.
So
I'm not going to do this.
So what you're saying is...
I'm not going to breathe for anybody. I'm breathing for myself.
All
right.
So what you're saying is that she can go to Tibet for the spiritual awakening and you're not interested.
I'm not interested in going to a spiritual awakening, no.
All right. Personally, and I don't mean to get personal, but I think you need a little of that.
I do need a little bit of it. That's here and there. That's between me. My wife. I can't even talk now.
Okay, now here's the deal. I am going to put you in touch with... You want me to put you in touch with my manager? This way he can work it out with you?
Yeah.
All right. Let me give you his name, okay?
Yeah, give me his name.
His name is Paul Barsky.
Oh, my God. Okay. Yeah, all right. I got to get off the phone.
Okay. Michael?
Hi, dear.
How are you?
Well, I'm horrified.
Oh, dear.
Why?
Why? Why are you laughing?
Why are you horrified?
Well, all of these people are driving me crazy.
Everybody
is trying to get me ready for my big interview.
Well, not only that, but you got the big album coming out, too, right? Right?
And it's all crazy.
But
all of these people, I told them in the song,
right.
Stop f***ing with me.
Stop what?
Stop f***ing with me.
Oh, Michael.
Well, those are the lyrics in the song.
Really?
It's crazy.
So you're actually cursing in the song.
I say the F word.
Wow.
And I say the S word.
Wow.
Well, I was very upset.
Yeah, but where did you learn that?
Where did I learn it?
Yeah, where did you hear that?
From my father.
Oh, all right. I don't want to bring it up.
George Jackson.
What?
Joe Jack. All the time. All the time.
Right.
All the time he would curse, all the time say, Michael, where's that f***ing money? And I would be very upset. I remember when I had my interview with Oprah.
Right.
I told her,
yeah.
Sometimes my father will come over for family reunion.
Right.
Make me want to vomit.
All right, I know.
I have to leave the room.
I know, because it makes you physically ill.
I have a very big interview coming up. It's wonderful.
I know. The big interview with Diane Sawyer. Now, are you prepared?
It's going to be on June the 14th, Wednesday.
Are you prepared for it?
Well, what do you mean prepared?
Well, I mean...
Not like I'm a politician. I'm going to tell the truth.
All right, let's pretend. Let's just role play here, because I want to make sure that you've got it together.
Well, I'm not going to tell her anything different than I told Oprah.
Okay, so I'm going to be Diane Sawyer now, all right?
Fine.
And I'll ask you the questions. You answer the way you would answer them on June 14th, okay? Now, Michael, let me ask you this question. A lot of people saying you and...
I love you.
Fine. Now, a lot of people saying that you and Lisa Marie, the whole marriage is a sham. It's a cover.
That's crazy.
Okay.
That's horrifying.
Now, why do you say that, Michael?
Well, it's appalling. It make me physically ill.
All right. So
there are crazy rumors. I love her. Here, watch.
What is that?
Then I'm going to kiss her on the mouth with my tongue.
Oh, I see.
That part I had to be taught.
All right, Michael, what's
going on? Well, wait a minute, Diane.
Yeah,
I want to tell you before you go the joke that has been circulating that has made me furious.
Oh, yeah, I want to hear this joke. I've heard about this, but I haven't heard the whole thing.
Well, it's got me going off the deep end.
All right, tell me it.
What do Michael Jackson and Shamu, the killer whale, have in common?
What?
They're both black and white and live in an amusement park.
Now that is not...
That's horrifying.
That's not nice at all.
That's crazy. I'm going to tell Diane. That's wild.
That's...
Why are you laughing?
Because it's just a very bad...
You thought that joke was funny.
No, it really wasn't.
No, you're crazy.
All right, Mike.
You are very insensitive.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Like George Jackson. Michael, give me the money.
All right.
But it was me. I was doing all the work.
I understand
I was the dancer.
I know that.
And the singer.
All right, listen.
And all he wanted was the money.
All right, don't get riled up and don't start cursing. Save
it
for the interview.
When he come over here, I'd make me want to blow a chunk.
Okay.
He's an asshole.
All right.
And that's my next song. It's called asshole. George Jackson's an asshole. I like to hear Casey Kasem say that on his countdown.
Hey, what would a CD be without a bowling scam? This guy used to walk around work bragging to all his friends about how great a bowler he was. And I guess it was his dream to be a professional bowler and to join the PBA. So they wanted me to call him as a scout from the PBA and have a little fun with him. And kind of went like this.
Oh,
yes, Gary?
Yeah?
You have a couple moments. My name is Mike Whippin with the PBA, the Professional Bowlers Association.
Yeah?
How are you, sir?
I'm okay. How are you?
Real good. The reason why I'm calling is because we received your name. It took a while to track you down, but I'm a scout with the PBA.
Okay.
And we have been looking at amateur bowlers in and around the Jersey, Philadelphia, New York area. We're looking to sign some new talent to be on the 95 PBA Tour. Have you thought about going professional?
Yes, I have.
All right. Let me ask, what is your current average right now?
195.
195. That's perfect. Because we're really not interested in anybody under 180. To be quite honest with you, I had a couple people out there take a look at you, and we didn't want to say anything because we didn't want to make you nervous. We were watching you. We liked what you did. We think you got a lot of natural talent. Now, what we're going to do, we're going to be having interviews in the area. I'm going to be over at the Roadside Inn in Cherry Hill next week. And we'll be holding interviews in the hotel room there.
Okay.
But what I want you to do now for the next week, there are a couple things that we like a lot of these people that we look at to do. We think it's very important to strengthen the fingers, obviously, the wrists, the legs. And I'll give you a couple of exercises to work on during the week. Have you ever done this exercise where you take a grapefruit and you squeeze as tight as you can until you put your fingers through the grapefruit?
Not with the grapefruit. I have squeezed the tennis ball.
All right, that's a good one, but the grapefruit is real good for you.
Okay.
Because it gives a little bit. The tennis ball sometimes tends to hurt the knuckles, and we don't want to cause any injury. So we suggest squeezing the grapefruit as tight as you possibly can. And I would suggest maybe buying a dozen, maybe, 20 grapefruits, and do this throughout the week, okay?
Sure.
Now, we're also interested in having you work on your approach, because I've just written some notes down on the paper here. One of the scouts is out looking at you, and he'd like you to work on your approach a little bit. Have you changed it up in the past year?
In the past year, no, not really. I'm still trying to get my timing down a little.
All right. Have you ever done the exercise where you skip backwards?
No, I haven't.
All right. Do you have a track there by your home or something like that where you can do that?
Yes, I do.
All right. What we'd like you to do is skip, if you can, and we want you to do this once a day, skip 4 miles backwards.
Okay, skip 4 miles. That'll be 16 times around the track.
About 16 times around the track. What this does is it strengthens the calf muscles and the thigh muscles. Okay?
Okay.
Now, let me go over what we're going to be doing in the hotel room, all right?
Okay.
We'll sit down, we'll discuss the tour, the scheduling, how it may cause a conflict with you or the family. We want to make sure we get that all out of the way in the beginning, okay?
Okay.
Then what I want you to do, I'm going to work on some of your motor skills, some reflex work, and then I'm going to test and see how strong your grip is and see if you've actually done what we asked you to do. And what you're going to do then is you're going to squeeze, and what I like to do here is have you squeeze my, let's say my thigh, and squeeze as tight as you can on my thigh, and if you can cause a bruise mark or a black and blue mark on the thigh, then I know you've got a very, very strong grip.
Okay.
You writing this down?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So now what exactly are you going to do now?
Okay, what I'm going to do with the grapefruit. You said to buy about 20.
Right.
And I'm going to squeeze it as hard as I can until I can put my fingers through it.
Right. Then what?
And then also, I'm going to skip 4 miles backwards.
Right.
As a matter of fact, there's two tracks around my area, so that won't be a problem.
All right. Then when you come to the hotel room, we have the interview, then what are you going to do?
What am I going to do? What we're going to do is you're going to give me your thigh, and I'm going to try and leave a bruise on it.
You're going to try to squeeze the hell out of my thigh and cause a hell of a bruise.
Okay.
As tight as you possibly can. Now, what I want you to do is bring the excess grapefruits that you don't use. Chances are you may not use all of them.
Okay.
And I'm going to stand up against a wall with my pants around my ankles, and you're going to throw the grapefruits as hard as you possibly can at my buttocks. And okay. Try to cause as big a bruise as you possibly can.
Okay.
Now, well, let's go over that again. What are they going to do now?
Okay.
In the hotel room.
I'm going to bring the excess grapefruit.
Right.
And you're going to have your pants around your ankles.
Right.
And I'm going to try and give you the biggest bruise on your buttocks.
And then after I'm done, you come down and kiss my buttocks and kiss them, but make them better, right?
Kiss the boo-boo, make it better.
This is a dream. There's a dream come true.
Yes, it is.
I'd like to set up an interview time, and I'm going to give you a number to call and call my secretary and set it up, all right?
Okay.
It's a male secretary.
Right.
Number is 1-800-232-1003.
232-1003.
And ask for Mr. Barsky from
Y100. Oh, man.
Oh, God.
Oh, man.
You're not kidding. Oh, man. You're actually going to throw grapefruits at this guy's butt? Oh, Jesus. Oh, God.
You guys, man. I got everybody at work laughing at me.
Then I want you to take the bowling ball, and I want you to crack it on the top of your head.
Oh, God.
Whatever you say, sir.
Christie Brinkley moves back with Billy Joel. Christie Brinkley and Billy Joel have rekindled their fairy tale romance just days after the leggy supermodel walked out on her new husband. Christie, 42. God, she looks great for 42.
Mm-hmm. Is that old?
Well,
I mean, you all say it like
not for me, it isn't. Christie fled back into Billy Joel's arms following the bust-up with real estate developer Ricky Taubman and spent several days hiding out at the singer's house in Nantucket. Quote, Christie went to Billy, and he welcomed her with open arms, said a source. Mm-hmm. The blonde beauty stayed on at the posh resort with a nanny and her two children, and the third one just had by Taubman. You think he's going to welcome her back with open arms like, I love you, come on back. Come on, tell me there's not a little bit of a vindictive streak in Billy Joel.
You don't know what kind of relationship they have, really.
I'll tell you what kind of relationship they have. Billy Joel says, okay, here's a credit card, you can shop. Just give me that thing. And give it to me two or three times a night. That's what that's all about. And I think what's going to happen is I think that Billy is going to take her in. He's going to pretend like he's a good buddy and a friend. Take her in and then kind of pull her into that relationship thing again and get what he can get. And then say, oh, by the way, one more thing. You're out of here. Because guys don't forget. Guys get even. So I figured that Billy should obviously write a song about this. He hasn't written a song. I've decided to write a song, and I'm singing it for him as if I was Billy Joel. Obviously, I'm not. But I will send this to him, and if he wants to re-record it, he can. And this is it. Hope you enjoy it on Y100.
What's the matter with the choice I'm making? Probably think I shouldn't take her back. Yes, it's true, she left me for another man, but she was so damn good in the sack. Yes, I think that this whole thing is funny. She married that Taubman guy cause she thought he had big money. I'll swallow my pride with my ex-bride. I can't hide what I feel inside. She's still a piece of tush to me. What's the matter with Christie, baby? Yeah, I know that she's kind of fickle. But I don't care about all of that now cause she really excites my pickle. Pretend to care and let her cry on my shoulder. Her ex-hubby's here and ready to console her. In the bedroom, ex-groom, ready for some boom boom. She's still a piece of tush to me. Oh, you may say that I'm really a fool, that she's just gonna hurt me again. But believe me, people, I'm not that dumb. Let's face it, Christie Brinkley's a 10. I'd like to do her in my den. So I'll sit back and be a good friend and pretend that I'm really listening. But I'll be thinking about her nude after sex in my bed with her body glistening. She made a mistake when she left me, now she'll pay. Bet you think I'm a bastard, well that's okay. Almost forgot that she's so hot, gonna get another shot. She's still a piece of tush to me. Oh, off, I guess I'm still in love with her. Even though she's had another man's baby, I remember the way we were. What the hell am I thinking? We all know the real reason. When the lights are out, it's time for sexual pleasing. Great sex with my ex, my condom's made of latex. She's still a piece of tush to me. The piano man's got a plan, thinking with my sexual glance. She's still a piece of tush to me.
Yeah!
Yeah!
There we go.
All right.
All right, this woman works at a collection agency, and her friends wanted us to call her and have a little fun with her, and they requested one of our characters by the name of Sid, and Sid decided to place the phone call.
This is Ms. Clay, can I help you?
Yes, Ms. Clay, this is Sidney Bluchem. I received this number to call you.
Uh-huh.
About, I owe money or something like that.
Okay, give me the file number.
File number?
Uh-huh.
Where would that be?
Do you have a letter from the attorney, or do you have a letter from the collection agency?
I don't know. It's a letter here.
And who's it from?
From you.
Okay. Right below the balance,
yes,
there's the CA number that starts 00.
Right.
What is that number?
00792875 3792.
Hold on, sir. Hello?
Hello?
I can't bring up your file. That's not the right number.
Excuse me.
Mm-hmm.
Should never have milk at first thing in the morning. What is your name again?
Jessica Clay.
Jessica.
Mm-hmm.
You sound like a very nice lady.
Well, I'm going to try to help you, sir, but I need to have the right information so I can bring up your file.
Well, forget about that for a second. Let me ask you a question.
Mm-hmm.
Are you a married woman?
Yes, sir.
Well, there goes that idea. I had a couple tickets to Fiddler on the Roof.
Oh, that would be nice.
Have you ever been to the 12 Caesars Dinner Theater?
No, sir.
It's a... Yeah. Hold on. I've been a widower for the last 12 years.
Uh-huh.
And I'm looking for someone to take to this thing.
Hmm.
Anybody there at the office who might be interested?
I don't think so. I think everybody here is married.
Hold on.
How do you spell your last name, sir?
Blachum. B-L-E-Chum. Blachum.
Okay, and how do you spell chum?
C-H-E-E-M.
C-H-E-M?
You got to admit, I'm one charming old man, aren't I? If you weren't married, you'd have your way with me, wouldn't you?
Yes, sweetheart.
Yes, you would. Could you believe I'm 73?
No.
73. How old are you, darling?
Myself?
Yes.
I'm 33.
Hey. If you haven't tried an old man yet, you're missing out on a great time. I got news for you. Why don't we just forget about this collection thing? I take you to Fiddler on the Roof and I give you a nice fur coat. Something like that?
Bless your heart.
Would that be nice?
I don't think so. I'm married.
The hell with him. He doesn't do nothing for you. If you were truly a happily married woman, you wouldn't be on the phone with me right now.
I'm talking to you because I'm trying to bring up your files.
Try me out.
Can't find it.
Try me.
Try you?
I get better with age.
Yeah, you're 72 years old?
73.
73, I'm sorry.
Yes.
You're getting younger every minute.
And I got these two tickets here. I don't know what the hell they're doing.
You're going to take me to Fiddler on the Roof. You're
yes.
Give me a fur coat.
Yes, I'll give you a fur coat.
What kind of fur?
And let me tell you something, Vinny. When I make love, I don't stop.
Uh-oh.
I don't stop. The only time I stop is if I die.
Oh, I don't want to be responsible for that.
Come on, sweetheart. Loosen up, damn it. Loosen up. I tell you what, can I have somebody else handle this for me? My attorney?
Sure. Just give the letter to your attorney and have him call.
Let me give you his name. His name is Barsky from Y100 Radio.
I have been phone scammed.
This is something we call Celebrity Rolodex, and Let me get the hokey music here, the hokey. There you go. Calling the stars, calling celebrities. Now, as you know, when we do Celebrity Rolodex, we don't like to call as ourselves. Because, first of all, we don't want to get hassled by anybody. So that's why we've decided to put two guys together who are considered to be the stereotypical cliche bad morning team.
Wait a second.
Hey.
Hey, man. Hey, how you doing, kangaroo?
I'm doing all right, man.
Yeah, it's the captain in the kangaroo with you. And a good morning.
Good morning.
Hey, let's get that celebrity Rolodex out here and see what we can make a phone call.
Time to get someone out of bed, man.
Try to get somebody out of bed and say good morning to you. Let's try calling.
Let me pick one here.
Hey, man. Hey, kangaroo.
Yeah?
What do you say we call Ted, Ted, is it Lang or Lange?
I think it's Lang.
I think it's Lang.
Man, is she alive?
I thought he was dead.
I sure enough did.
Hello?
Hey, is this a Ted Lang?
Yeah.
Ted, hi.
Hey.
How you doing, man?
Fine.
It's the captain and the kangaroo for the morning zoo calling. How are you?
Big
Where
fan.
Are you guys? Where? What city are you in?
We're in at the morning zoo in Philadelphia.
Philadelphia,
Pennsylvania.
W.C. Fields' favorite city.
That's right. What did W.C. Fields say? He said something.
He went there and it was closed.
Yeah. Man.
Woo!
Man, we
you
should
don't
have,
remember that? No, you guys must be kids.
We should have Ted write for us, man. That is a funny line.
Oh, man.
Hey, I didn't write it. Fields wrote it.
Wait a second. Let me write this down. I went to Philadelphia, but it was closed.
Yeah. That's good stuff, Ted. That is good stuff.
What radio station is this?
This is WILD.
WILD owes me a t-shirt.
All right, man. We'll get you a t-shirt, man.
Yeah, all right,
now,
man.
Now, listen. Listen to me.
What?
We're really looking for a reunion show. And the reason why I'm calling because I've been hearing all sorts of rumors about the big reunion show.
Where'd you hear a rumor?
I can't tell you where I heard it. It's confidential.
It's confidential.
Actually, Kangaroo heard it. Would you hear it?
Man, it's a rumor, man.
It's a rumor.
Okay, well,
that's
listen. You guys better get better writers, too.
No, we are in the
Maybe
business.
I should be doing some writing for you guys.
Let me explain something.
There's no rumor. It's not happening.
Now,
there's no reunion show.
Well, now, wait a second now.
What? I'm honest, man. I know all the guys connected to it.
Well, I thought, first of all, that it was one of the best shows I'd ever seen, and I thought you were great. And the fact that you played a butler with an attitude, man, I thought that was a groundbreaking idea.
Well,
man,
I was not a butler, though.
What do you mean you weren't a butler?
I wasn't a butler.
Oh, come on, man.
I was a bartender.
No, wait a second.
You never watched the show. You don't even know what the show is.
Benson.
Benson, man.
Benson. Oh, Benson. That's another one.
Yeah, that was you.
No, that's Robert Guillaume, man.
Oh, come on, man. That was you.
You got the wrong phone number.
Wait, that was you.
They gave you the wrong phone number.
No, they didn't. No, wait a second. It was Ted Lang was Benson, man.
No, it was Ted Lang, and it was Love Boat.
Oh, wait a second. You are... No. This is the guy that was the host of the dating game, Ted Lang.
Yeah,
man. Jim Lang.
Who?
Jim Lang.
Who the hell's that?
That's the brother of Hope Lang.
Jessica Lang.
Jessica Lang now, yeah.
So you're married to Jessica Lang?
I was, but she got an Academy Award and split.
Man, everybody's splitting from you.
Yeah,
man,
I can't understand
what's up with
it.
You got to get yourself another show, man.
Well, I don't want to do it. I want to do theater. I don't want to do any more television.
No, you want to get yourself another one of those shows.
If I do television, you know what happens is they mistake me with Robert Guillaume, so what's the point?
No, really, you need the original one, man. Get yourself another one of those butler shows.
I never did a butler show. I'm trying to tell you this.
Man, maybe you should do one.
Maybe, yeah.
That could be the doorway
show.
For you.
Maybe. There's a lot of black people who would like me to progress a little further than that. I hate to tell you this.
What do you mean? What's wrong with being a butler?
Nothing.
How about a lawn jockey?
Oh, cross the line there, man.
Oh, man. Oh, boy. I'm a shock jock.
Man, this is Philadelphia. You sure this isn't Roanoke?
Man, he's back. He's back.
He's hot. Hey, man, do some stand-up. Because you're funny.
Oh, yeah, I did some stand-up.
You got to.
Nah, it wasn't very good, actually.
Nah, not to
man,
us.
Man, you got a home on our show anytime you want to be on, man.
Let me just say this.
Right?
Having you on the show, home run.
Home.
You hit a home run.
Okay.
We love you.
You hit the bull in the eye. We got the free steak, man.
And we're going to be out there in a couple of weeks. This vacation. Can we come out and hang with you?
Yeah, sure you can.
That will stop
you. If you buy the drinks.
No problem.
You going to buy the drinks?
Well, you'll mix them.
You mix them up, man.
You mix them up.
No.
And you serve them. You're the butler.
That's right.
I'm not the butler. I'm not the bartender.
All right.
I'm the baddest dude.
You are bad, man.
Hey, man.
Bad.
I'm the bad brother.
With a capital B.
Capital B.
B-A-D, bad, baby.
All right.
All right. We'll talk to you later, man.
Okay.
Right on.
Bye.
Hey, bye-bye.
This woman had a trip planned to New Orleans for Mardi Gras, and she was totally stressed out at work, and so we decided to call from the airline to tell her that there's been a change in plans.
Hello?
The Evans, please.
This is she.
Hi, Miss Evans. This is Mr. Morris of the U.S. Air.
Uh-huh.
Are you scheduled to fly out tonight?
Yeah.
Flight 224?
New Orleans?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
The flight has been canceled. We're having a problem with one of the planes. We're going to have to put you on another plane and reroute you.
What?
We're going to have to reroute you.
I have to get there. It's like a huge party.
Oh, huge party? Get a pen and pencil. We'll get you there.
Okay, hold on.
Don't
hold
get
on,
up.
Hold on. Okay,
D?
Maria, give me a pen! Okay.
Okay, you're obviously flying down for the big Mardi Gras Tuesday
yes,
celebration. Okay.
Yes, I'm supposed to be there until Wednesday, and, like, I made all my... my mom paid, like, $700 for this place.
Okay, well, this is...
It, like, 3 days before I was going to go.
All right, this is not going to cost you any more, so don't even worry about it. All right?
Okay.
You're all calm now?
Oh, yes.
Good.
Okay, I'm calm now.
All
I'm
right.
Like, no, I have to go. I have to party. I'm, like, so stressed out at work.
You're stressed out, so you got to go out and you have to party. I understand. I'm right with you. Believe okay. me, if I could go with you, I would.
Okay, go ahead.
Now, you got a pencil and paper?
Yeah.
Okay, here's the deal. We're going to get you out. You were supposed to leave at 7:35. We're going to actually get you out at 8:40.
Okay.
Okay? Flight 353. Writing this down?
Uh-huh.
Leaving Philadelphia at 8:40. Arriving in Cleveland at 9:53.
Cleveland?
Yes. We just have to do a little rerouting here. Okay?
Well,
and then you're going to get on flight 1907.
1907?
In Cleveland.
In Cleveland.
You will leave at 10:15 and arrive in Houston at 1:05.
Houston?
Yes, it's a hub.
Oh, my God. They're, like, sending me across the... Listen.
Yes.
Listen, I just paid $700
right.
for a ticket.
All right, well, let me just continue here. In Houston, you will get on flight 2530 at 2:20 a.m.
2:20 a.m.?
And you will fly to St. Louis.
Mom!
And, what?
Mom! 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 Come here! Mother! Oh, my God, no.
Well, you'll
run. Listen to me.
What?
No.
Calm down, Dee.
Oh, my God. Wait a minute. You can't do...
Dee, relax.
I have reservations at a hotel. I'm supposed to be there by 11 o'clock tonight.
Oh, that's not going to happen. Now, you're going to be in St. Louis at 4:30 a.m. You will jump on flight 1010 at 5:05 from St. Louis, and you will arrive in Baton Rouge at 7:48.
Oh.
At that point...
Just send me to Byberry because that's... No, you cannot do
no.
this.
And then at 7...
Listen, what is your name?
Mr. Morris.
Mr. Morris.
Yes.
Mr. Morris,
yes.
sir.
Yes.
I'm really, really thankful that you're trying to get me there.
Yes, I'm trying my best.
But that's not going
to
do.
All right, well, listen to me. You'll be
no,
in Baton Rouge at 7:40.
Mr. Morris, sir, you
yes.
listen to me.
Yes, okay.
My mother just shelled out almost $2,000 for me to go
right.
take a vacation. Listen.
I understand. If you don't calm down, you're going to end up in a mental institution.
Listen,
yes.
I just broke up with my fiance.
Yes.
Hey, okay? I really need to get out of here.
I will
if
get
I
you there.
Get out of here and be in New Orleans
okay.
at Mardi Gras on Bourbon Street.
Okay, listen. Listen to me, sweetheart. Listen to me. Just calm down. Listen to what I have to tell you here, okay? And if it doesn't sit well with you, then we'll change it, okay?
Oh, Mr. Morris, I'm going to come to U.S. Air, and there's going to be a real big problem.
All right, well, listen to me. 7:48 in Baton Rouge, you will board a bus that'll take you from Baton Rouge into New Orleans. You will board. Listen, you will.
No, I'm not taking a bus. I refuse to take a bus.
You gotta calm down.
New Orleans, I can't. I cannot. You don't understand.
You're gonna jump on the Barsky bus for mentally insane people who need a vacation.
You did this to me. Oh my God.
Man.
Barsky in the morning for you, my 100.
You've got to calm. Jesus. You gotta calm down. Sister, man, you need a vacation.
Oh, God, I Woo. Was like, you have me shaking like a leaf.
All I'm right.
like, no.
Now you have a real reason to go out and have a vacation,
oh,
huh?
Jesus.
All right, go have a hurricane for me.
Thank you. Well, not thanks, but...
Yeah, I understand.
Thanks.
Have a good time.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
All right, this is a phone scam we happen to do on a friend of Sherry's who also happens to be African-American. And I guess he was throwing a big party slash dance slash get-together at a hotel. And we decided to call from the hotel to have a little fun with him. And this is what it sounded like.
Hello?
Yes, sir. Fred Purnell, please. Mr. Clavin from the hotel. Mr. Purnell?
Yes.
We have a booking problem. You have an affair booked for the 28th?
Yeah.
Okay, we unfortunately have somebody made a mistake on our end. We apologize, but we have an overbooking problem. We've already booked that date.
Booked what?
We've booked the date for in the Grand Ballroom. We've got another convention in there.
Another convention?
Yes.
How do you figure that?
Well, it's already been booked.
It's already been booked. We booked it, 2 months ago, man?
Yeah, this was booked 4 months ago.
Four.
Yeah, unfortunately, one of our employees, who is no longer with us, forgot to tell us the information.
That's crazy, man.
Well, I apologize.
Oh, we didn't spend over like 10 grand on this party. What are you talking about?
Well, what I'm saying to you is that it's overbooked and that we're going to have to put you in a different room, or can you schedule for another day?
You must be out of your mind, man.
Well, I'm not out of my mind. I'm trying to give you the information here, and I'm trying to work this out with you, sir.
Work this out, man. This is crazy.
Well, why is it crazy?
Why is it crazy?
Yes.
We spent ten grand, man. What are you talking about?
Well, I understand you spent that. That's fine and dandy. But the problem we have right now is this is out of my hands. This was done by somebody else.
Out of your hands? Well, who are you?
Well, I am the booking manager.
Booking manager?
Yes.
We got airtime this week with Power 99 and VAS. We spent like $3,000 on that.
I understand that.
How are we going to get our money back with that? It's late.
Right. What I'm saying to you that
you got to compensate us some way.
Well, I don't know if we can do that, but we can put you in a different room.
What do you mean you can't do it?
We can put you in another room.
You can't put me in another room. We're expecting 3,000 people, man. What are you talking about?
Well, then we're going to have to break you up in different rooms. But the bottom line is we've already booked this 4 months in advance, and there's another convention.
Well, you're here from our lawyer. I mean, let me get your name and number, because you're here from my lawyer.
All right. My name
within an hour.
My name is Mr. Clavin. Now, you know, 4 months ago, they booked the Pennsylvania chapter of the Ku Klux Klan in there for a convention.
Ku Klux Klan?
Yeah, that was 4 months ago, the Pennsylvania chapter, and they've already put their deposit down. So
wait, y'all some racist motherfuckers. You know what?
No.
My lawyer in a minute.
No, wait a second now. Sir?
What?
No, there's nothing racist about this.
That's
just
man.
No, we just ran out to the first available party that comes in and decides to put the money down. Now, listen, my brother.
How the fuck you going to change that man?
Listen, my brother, calm down.
Ain't your motherfucking brother, man.
Yes, you are. You and I are brothers. Just because I am from a different side of the spectrum, you and I are together. We're brothers.
Yeah, you fucking crazy.
Sing
you're here for my lawyer in a little
bit. Wait a second now. Wait a second. Let's work this out. Would you sing Ebony and Ivory with me, please?
Yeah. Man, kiss my ass.
Ebony.
You know what? I'm going to sue you, motherfucking ass. You know what?
Why don't you
We're going to lose about 30 fucking grand because you're a stupid motherfucking mistake.
Well, I apologize for that, sir.
Huh?
Why are you so worked up?
Why are you worked up? If you're going to lose 30 fucking grand, wouldn't you be worked up?
Okay. Let me tell you something. Can you contact our lawyer?
I ain't worried about your lawyer. What's your lawyer's number?
Well, let me give you the lawyer's name here, okay?
Yeah.
Lawyer's name is Barsky from Y100.
Yeah. We're Sherry, man.
She's right here.
Oh, man, you suck. She's sick, man.
Underrated.
Hey, this city wants a winning team. Don't screw it up, don't show,
or else you may be hated.
Hey, here comes the pass. They shoot, they storm, they celebrate, and then they'll kick your ass. Hey.
called Sean Podine, Sean Podier. Didn't know all the players got the other names wrong, but it's never too late to become a fan, especially when they're winning. I'm a bandwagon man. We're the Legion of Doom out leading the way. They're gonna knock you to the ice, not once but twice. They don't play nice. Hey! Heck no, don't let the pucks slip through, cause if you do, the fans will be frustrated. Hey! Philly wants a Stanley Cup. Let's keep it up. You know how long we've waited. Hey, here comes the pass. They shoot, they score, they celebrate, and then they'll kick your ass. Hey, will the boys come out and play? Eric Lindros, Brenda Moore, and LeClaire. They got that's rare. They're gonna do their best to bring home the cup. They're gonna fight all night, do it right, maybe even scratch it, but hey, it's the Flyers all the way. Just listen to the buzz that we've created. Hey, one more thing I have to say, then listen to my show, for that I am elated. Hey, here comes the